everybody, and welcome back to Darksiders 3 with Chaos Counseling. Ooh, let's bird shit.
Stuff.
We can do this on our own. We don't need Fire Muffin anymore.
Fire Muffin. Well, I guess that means that Fire Muffin can live.
Yay!
Forever.
And I learned last time I can actually walk through this.
We kind of fell off last time when we were just messing around and
just let us live. So we had to burn ourselves alive. Ooh.
Big jump! Incredible. Well, I'm glad she likes it.
Mm-hmm.
At least. Oh.
Hello?
I thought her head smack against the roof made that metal clanking sound. What? So I was like, what is your head made out of, Fury?
Nice.
I love the design of this place already.
Part demon, so...
there are four hollow... Wait, are there... Yes, there are four hollows, and I got a fire one, so I hope there's a hollow for each element.
Oh, an RPG where you have to collect all the elements.
I know.
Heard that one
we have a whipping main character, seven deadly sins, the elements. I'm literally trash for anything with the elements.
The only thing it's missing is a pterodactyl.
No, it's also missing tarot cards.
Pterodactyl.
Won't be long.
Oh my god! Why isn't that a thing?
What the hell?
I'm sure it is.
Hello.
Oh, it's a trigger.
So I need to find something to put on the trigger.
Or can you jump in? And then just be trapped on
it
the
is
edge.
A
oh. Oh, that's where you came from.
Yeah, maybe you
I think you can just jump
run
in.
Through it. Maybe. Okay. I don't know. I didn't pay attention to the delay time, unfortunately.
It,
so
it
could be
took
wrong.
A little bit.
Okay, I just tried to Google tarot, as in tarot card, dactyl. It brought up Charizard? It brought up Charizard.
Oh no, like, oh. Step on the button, let it turn all the way around, and then hop in.
Okay.
To the other thing. That part.
Yeah, the little homey thing when I saw that, I was like, oh, hello. It's
hello?
Like, you're inviting
hello?
Us hello?
Hello? I would laugh so hard if we found humans in here. It's like, what are you, how the fuck did you get here?
Hello?
Honey, we're not on Earth.
We're in the hollows. That's what he
where
said.
Where are the hollows?
That's a good question.
I assume if
shattering
he's a demon, it's in hell.
When you get,
everything.
Like, ground, and it has a dip in the middle.
I will punch you.
It's called a hollow. So you get a hole.
Oh. You
to pay me a visit. I trust the slaying is going well.
None of your concern, demon.
Your tone betrays you, horseman. You see, I was right after all, yes? You and your kin have been deceived.
That's no secret. But by who?
Just play the first game.
Angels are the most likely suspect. Wouldn't you agree after what happened to dear old Rampage?
Don't remind me, you ass!
You are not fit to speak his name.
No need to unleash your might on me, horseman. Look to those who would benefit from your failure. Your enemies are closer than you think.
It's you. I knew it.
Take your time.
Wouldn't that be a big plot twist?
And focus rage. Rejuvenation.
And Bolgrim was the bad guy.
Name, he still has this game.
As you wish.
And an impossible sequel to prove that.
As you wish. Take your time.
Because he says our enemies are closer than you, we think, so. It could
as
be him.
This would be fun for both of us.
You've never seen
as
the face of the Prince of Darkness. You've only heard his voice when he was talking to Lilith at the end of the second game.
That is true.
I mean, granted, that wasn't Wolgrim's voice, but
no.
Voice modulation is a thing.
Demons can do that, right?
So, he mentioned something about your horse?
Brought up
like
Rampage.
Like a bitka.
And she's all like, you're not fit to speak his name.
Like, lol.
Okay, so obviously it's meant, you know, I'm just going to say it. It was meant to be obvious. Rampage is dead.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what?
Yeah, that's... I was hoping maybe, you know, okay, is Rampage going to come back later? It's like, no, the horse is actually dead.
Yeah, and that was confirmation right there to find out. So.
And something that kind of I find funny is... One of the major complaints about the first game was that you're a horseman of the apocalypse, but you don't have your horse for most of the game, which is why the developers felt it important to have the second game open with death on his horse. Now they're taking the horse away completely.
We had an intro scene with the horse still, but...
But we never actually got to ride the horse.
Well...
And it's just like, that sucks. The horses were always just such a... just because even in the books, death had such a great relationship with despair. I'm just... man, that sucks.
Imagine how Fury feels.
I'm mad at the game for doing that per se, because it's good...
Oh, hello.
...character, you know, thing for Fury. It's just... man, it feels just like a missed opportunity.
I'm gonna be strangled for this. I guess you could say Furious. Furious.
I think it's actually...
assume the strangulation position.
I assume, actually, really, it kind of makes sense that they would take the horse away from the horseman. Because
mm-hmm.
yeah. it's like, you're not the horseman anymore.
And especially
you got
if
no
the
horse.
Enemies wanted to, you know, get under, like, you defeat mm-hmm. them for one reason or another, it would make sense, you know, to take away their namesake.
Yeah. I mean, heck, Ruin in the first game was full on, you know, taken by demons and tortured.
Yeah, so...
Granted, the biggest one of the complaints I have about that in the first game was Ruin came out of nowhere. There was no setup or build-up as to how he ended up with the demon. It was just, Ruin, I won't hurt you. Yay, I've got your horse back. Sorry, you were saying something, please?
I don't remember what I was saying.
Oh, hi.
Hi, you're not...
Bye.
Holy freak!
Okay.
I'm sorry that. Oh.
Hey, bitch. Don't do that again.
I'm sorry. That was actually pretty cool to watch.
That was amazing. What an asshole.
Oh, boy.
Yep.
This game seems harder than the previous two. That or you just really suck.
I think it's harder.
I suck a lot.
I think it's harder just based. Well, okay.
Sunshine. Sunshine, do you need to come out of the closet? I mean, I'm not judging if you do.
Oh, boy.
I was going to say that I've noticed that the enemies have been dealing a lot of damage.
Yeah.
So it is really prioritizing you to use your dodge mechanics.
I wonder if the difficulty can be changed.
From, like,
in the middle of the game?
Easy to sad.
That's, like, a difficulty I always play on.
Me too.
Sad.
I want that to be a difficulty.
Oh, yeah. So, I think the one game...
I think that's what our Discord calls it.
I was looking for story. That's the name of the difficulty, but I couldn't think of it, so I just went with sad.
No, that's true, though. That's what every gamer always tells me. I'm just like, oh, I play the super easy mode. They're like, that's sad.
Yeah,
and
I love Mass
Effect. I think they were actually just correcting me this entire time.
Yeah, I love Mass Effect, but I've never played it on anything other than casual because I'm not there for the easy. I'm like, I'm not there for the challenge. I'm there for the story. Sue me.
Yeah, it's just priority.
Granted, Mass Effect 3 in multiplayer, I did get all the way up to platinum. Then they patched in a whole bunch of new enemies and made them an absolute pain in the ass to deal with.
Well.
They still gotta get you a season pass so you can try the Andromeda multiplayer.
Yeah, even if it's still
going on. People play
on
it.
I miss Mass Effect 3's multiplayer. That was so much fun. Me and my older brother, or our older brother, I guess, Sunshine, we would spend hours playing it together.
I tried once. I sucked.
Granted, I could never.
Everyone was really mad at me.
That's why we played on easy mode.
Everyone was still really mad at me.
Yeah. Honestly, I think the one. I had people cussing me out the first time I tried playing Halo online. Actually, I still kept playing Halo online, but I kind of restricted myself to a couple certain modes, like zombies and SWAT. Because it kept everyone in confined quarters, so I didn't have to wonder how they were sniping me from across the map with a pistol or something like that.
Anyone who did that must have been hacking. You can snipe with a pistol, that's crazy.
Well, actually, a running gag is Halo has always had overpowered pistols. Like, in the first game, the pistols were the most effective item in the game.
Oh.
Because the people who made the game had never shot a gun in their life, so...
Oh.
The funny thing is that everyone jokes that the pistols got nerfed because after they kind of realized their mistakes, they actually went out in the shooting range and actually shot weapons in order to properly rebalance the game. However, because, you know, Halo Reach takes place before the first game, they decided it would make sense to give the pistol its ability to zoom in and scope. So it became a little broken again. Nowhere near as bad as it was in the first game, but still.
Oh, good job!
Finally.
Way to go.
Are you kidding me?
What? Are you serious?
They blow up!
What?
Are you kidding
me? What bullshit? Game designer, what the shit?
Oh, well, I mean, to be fair, there were explosive enemies in the first game. I remember they gave you some trouble, honey.
Yeah, but do they one-shot you?
Well, but he was pretty low on health anyway.
Who's half?
I don't know.
That's pretty high. It does feel like things are a little bit imbalanced.
Yeah. Then again, someone here compared it to, like, Dark Souls and Bloodborne, so...
Well, yeah, but that was the...
That was a joke.
It was a joke.
Well, now it's actually coming to fruition.
Oh, so I don't know if any of you...
You jinxed us.
So after playing Warrior All-Stars, I bought a bunch of the games that the characters are from. There's one up there called Neo. When I first played it, I'm like, this game is great. After playing it, I'm like, this is one of the hardest games I've ever played in my entire life. Because if you die, all the enemies respawn. And you can't... So you can't actually save your progress. It's like... Oh, man, it was awful.
Well.
And we start back over again.
Is that like a reference to do that? And it's funny, but...
He's done it before, so that I get it from him.
Sunshine. It's not a reference.
I don't know.
I just kind of clap to it. It just feels natural.
Yeah, I mean, it sounds right, so like I'm
I just randomly thought, I still need to talk to everyone but Jesse about what I'm going to need your help with that song I told you about.
Oh.
The one that's going to, I'm convinced, is not going to make me make a performance check because Jesse's going to like it that much.
Flashback references.
That's definitely, you're definitely not going to know what that is because... That's still forever away flashback
wise. If this does still come out in December, I hope I can get this out in December.
Yeah. I believe.
If that's the case, school got ahead of me. I don't have the art ready for the next arc.
Okay.
So,
oh, bless your heart.
Flashback will return in 2019. But it will be back.
Yes. It will be glorious.
I have... sketches.
It gives us time to record some more because we're catching up real quick.
Yep.
We're almost to the third chapter.
I know.
And you can transform this time.
Oh my gosh.
Do it. Oh, you died. What the fuck?
We'll be right back after these profanities.
What the fuck?
For reference. That was 3 hits.
Wow. Difficulty balanced? Bullshit. Denied. But well, now we'll never know if it's a balanced video game.
I think Sunshine will live.
Well, we're back.
Yep.
I just rage quit. What's that moat?
Rage balanced. We left balance.
We're on story mode.
Yeah. We're on sad.
We're on sad.
But you know what?
Oh,
it feels good.
It's also on sane mode.
How do you get up?
Oh, you can high jump.
Yeah, you can fart your way up there.
I mean, that's one way of putting it.
I suppose.
Oh, just the switch.
Sorry, I should have. Oh, okay.
Hit your head.
Oh, Fury's head. Fury's head again.
Oh, we got it.
That worked.
Okay.
Egg. Rise.
So hopefully sad mode will fit our requirements.
Well, I mean,
I'm so sorry.
We're hunting the 7 deadly sins. Why not spend the time with the 5 core emotions?
And also we've lost Rampage. We can be sad.
There were moments playing Darksiders 2. I was tempted to go to beginner.
Aw, bless you.
You know...
The fact that you didn't.
Yeah, that's impressive.
I bet the only reason why Rampage was killed was because the Rampage movie wasn't very good.
Uh-oh.
And again, it's a movie based off a video game, so I don't know what I was expecting.
I was gonna say,
some
it's par
of them
for
are
the course.
Good.
Really? Which ones have you seen?
I saw Warcraft, and I thought it was very good.
You thought Warcraft was good?
I loved Warcraft.
Oh, that's so good!
Yeah,
Prince of Persia was pretty good. It wasn't great.
Yes!
Increased capacity. Away.
Hello.
Hello.
There's, in my opinion, very rare good video game movies, which is why I'm kind of scared for Detective Pikachu.
I am so excited.
You've got Ryan Reynolds as Detective Pikachu.
I'm just gonna. What the fuck?
Something happened.
Oh, the controller probably died. Oh no, it was loading.
No, it was loading.
I think it's gonna be stupid and fun, and I'm so excited.
Yeah, the fact that Ryan Reynolds is the one who actually got it for us.
Yeah. I'm disappointed they didn't get Danny DeVito, though. Can you imagine?
Danny DeVito Pikachu.
Oh my
gosh. Danny DeVito Pikachu.
No.
That would have been amazing.
Nah, friend.
Yes.
Danny DeVito Mewtwo.
Oh my god!
That's the plot twist!
I need an impression.
Danny DeVito.
So,
I don't want Danny DeVito to die.
Well, they don't die, they faint.
Yeah.
Haven't you heard that the Mewtwo role's cursed?
Oh, right. Oh. I forgot about that curse.
Oh.
Anyone who's voiced Mewtwo dies.
No.
Oh, no.
The first guy died. Dan Green's wife died.
Aww.
I don't know. I haven't actually looked up about the woman who voiced Mewtwo in the X and Y movie, if she's okay.
There is a Mewtwo curse.
This got heavy. How about we have Danny DeVito play Mew?
Even better.
Yeah.
Better. Oh. Can they...
I didn't mean to do that.
Oh, that's well. Okay.
We could look awesome.
That's okay. We could look hot.
Hey.
I'm okay with
it. Oh,
this.
But, yeah, I'm pretty sure Mewtwo is going to be in the movie because I think it's going to follow the video game plot.
No.
No?
Have you seen the trailer?
Well, I mean, yeah, but have you played the game?
No. That's fair. Can I borrow it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, cool. It's for 3DS, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Is there a human?
Let me go grab it so I don't forget.
I'll grab it later.
Let me grab it. I'm closer.
No. We're recording. Sit down.
I never stood up.
I know. I was preventing it.
But yeah, it's
Chrissy,
actually really
you
good.
You couldn't stop me from getting up if you really wanted to.
That's true.
Unless you sat on me.
I don't know how to feel about that.
Well, let me rephrase that. If you sat on me on this couch.
I don't know how to feel about that. But okay.
For funsies, I'm going to endorse some Detective Pikachu. If you guys like Pokemans, I highly recommend the game.
Okay.
It's definitely, you know, a detective game for children.
Oh.
Definitely, because some of the puzzles are very much, you know, just for kids.
I love it.
But at the same
time...
Can
I show everyone my badge?
No.
Because
you are... Never mind,
I don't want to borrow it now.
Only Kendall's allowed to show her kitty badge.
What?
Has whiskers on it.
I meant kitty as in, like, little kid.
Like her cardboard cutout badge that she has.
Has whiskers on it.
Just as a reference, the first we played Pokemon D&D with Kendall and her cousin.
Oh!
And her character was an investigator.
You can walk across lava.
I know, but
it's fine.
There's nothing we can do with it.
Mm. And Kendall's character was a detective. She was an investigator. Yeah, she was something. And for fun, she made herself a cardboard detective badge. Well, when she made
burn that! Burn that webbing! Don't get...
Webs and nothing. I get it!
Ah...
There were a way to use them to reach that person.
Can you... Because you don't have any ranged attacks yet.
No.
The investigator bit.
Oh, yeah, so she did a bluff check.
Wait, is there stuff on the ceiling?
And got like a natural 20 on it.
Never mind.
So I just decided as a joke, she would have like a permanent...
Oh,
burn it over there. That way by the time it gets over there, you can hit the switches at the same time.
I think
can you high jump and then hit it?
Ah.
There it goes.
Anyway, but yeah,
The nice thing about Detective Pikachu is actually it will some occasionally like do some
nice.
Not dark themes or anything, but it's
heavier,
and it was interesting. It was kind of nice. Heavy for kids.
Interesting.
Interesting.
I think that should call it for an episode. Okay. Actually. Oh. I wasn't here. saw nothing.
I'm just gonna... There. Nope, I didn't see a lady with her hair on fire. It must be some other person.
Yeah.
Goodbye.